You look out the window and watch the climate change happen.
I think Ilulissat is one of the most dramatic places in Greenland to see climate change because it has one of the largest glaciers in Ilulissat Ice Fjord, and it has some of the biggest changes. You know, that band of clean exposed bedrock that I was talking about, it's really wide. It's huge in Ilulissat. And you can see the glacier flowing into the sea and just how high the stresses are and the ice dynamics causing all those cracks and the icebergs flowing in the ocean. It's a very dramatic setting. So when you stand on the fjord wall and you watch those icebergs slowly going into the ocean, you're watching about 1% of the global sea level rise contribution leaving Greenland and going into the ocean. It's one of the biggest point sources of ice loss from the ice sheet today.
Cannot get around that. We can come up with a lot of other factors that might influence it, but our carbon footprint is the key factor in this aspect, because we don't get around the fact that it is our carbon emissions that are the key factor in this.
How I feel about this is the clock has started, and the clock now is going much faster. We're constantly speeding it up. So what we're asking our kids to do is we want them to stop the clock. We have to stop it now, because by the time it gets to them, the clock will be way too fast. They won't have the time left to make a difference. We have the time now to make a difference. They won't. So I hope we actually do something so our future generations can walk on this beautiful glacier again.
Those of us who study climate change, we think we have a pretty good idea of how it's happening and how it's happening faster than politicians are reacting. But an event like that comes and it's happening even faster than I think it should be happening, which makes me a little cautious about where we're going in the future. It's happening faster than we forecast at the moment.
The world will not end. If we get climate change, it will be a new situation. But we will not all die, and the Earth will not end. It will just be another one.
Yes.
And it's very important that the young people do not panic and say, oh, now everything stops. No, we have to take the challenge to think, to adapt, and to cut back on emissions in a sensible way.
Yes.
But take it easy.
Don't panic.
My message is very simple. Please, please, please stop burning fossil fuels and go on renewables. Wind, solar, hydropower, whatever. That would be so lovely.
We can always do something individually. We don't have to wait for others to do so or tell us to do. And I think it's very important that we all think that we can start today. We don't have to wait.
So I think focus should be replacing fossil fuel on very large volume consumers like power plants or production facilities in general.
Our neighbors are burning, we are drowning. So please be more thoughtful of your fossil fuel consumption and commute to work by public transport at least once a week. That would be nice.
I would love to say that we would love to see more education about the climate changes and more connection between the different countries, generally in all of the countries, about the climate change that is happening now. Because after all, climate change is under children's rights. Every child has the right to live in good conditions.
I have and quite big workshops where I have had all from local hunters to you know, and also representatives from the scientific community, and then all the relevant stakeholders, both national and international stakeholders, in relation to these issues, simply to discuss what are the important issues and how can we solve them together. I don't want to stimulate the ideas. I want to facilitate the process of getting the ideas, and I think that's one of the things that I can actually, that I can make people with very different backgrounds cooperate, and that's maybe my best quality.
解凍格陵蘭采访记录团队亲自造访11个城镇，与专家学者、政府官员。 当地居民深度访谈，气候变迁已经是不争的事实。因应调适跟积极的付诸行动，才是我们每一位都必须面对的课题。然而，格陵兰的冰融。 也带来了丰沛的水利资源，使得这里的再生能源使用率超过了60%。孩子们能在夏季的溪边开心玩水，变暖的洋流带来了丰富的渔业资源，从冰层中裸露的土地有着更多的可供畜牧、耕种的农业发展机会。我大胆地预言，渐渐地，在北极的格陵兰将成为宜居的城市。
The effects of climate change are being felt in all corners of the globe every day. Everybody has their part to play in limiting these effects: governments, businesses, and consumers. There are some great news stories. For example, wind and solar are now the cheapest form of electricity in many countries around the world, and an increasing number of businesses, for example, the ones that we work with, the RE100, are transitioning to 100% renewable electricity because it makes business sense. But we need to go further and faster, much faster. It's time for everybody to step up and take action.
The best advice I feel I can give to this documentary is to support civil society to become more active in promoting solutions to climate change. And I think there are two key roles that civil society can play. One is as voters, and put pressure on politicians and governments to be more aware of the impacts of climate change, and that we need to find solutions very soon to climate change. The second is becoming active consumers and put pressure on business to deliver more green products in line with the net zero targets, and also, of course, products that are green more green in totality. And I think that, that the more you can link what you're doing on spot, on site, different places in the world, to the global movements for civil society, the more impact the documentary will have.